हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज मिसेज अक्षा शिरोडकर फ्रॉम सेठ विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस. सो वी विल सी फ्रॉम द चैप्टर 2 कंप्यूटर साइंस पेपर 2 इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट ऑफ 1885 द ब्रांचिंग ग्रुप. सो टुडे विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद द फोर्थ ग्रुप विच इज़ द ब्रांचिंग ग्रुप. नाउ लेट मी टेल यू ऑल दैट दीज टू ग्रुप्स दैट इज द ब्रांचिंग फोर्थ वन एंड द फिफ्थ वन विच इज the stack and control group is not that important as compared to the three groups which I told you all which we have completed, that is the data transfer, arithmetic and logical group. These three groups are very very important with all the instructions that you have to learn, and this particular fourth group, that is a branching group, and the stack and control, also called as machine control. So these two groups are not that important. We do not require these two groups in the particular practicals, and they won't be asking much in the theory paper. Much in the theory paper of computer science. So the branching instruction will be starting with the first instruction. You need to note down the number of instructions because I have not noted down the instruction number here. So the branching instruction is, the first is JMP ADDR, also called as JMP. So the name for this particular jump instruction is unconditional jump. We have two sections here for every instructions now, the conditional one and unconditional one. So the unconditional jump means what happens, the control is always transferred unconditionally to the memory location whose address is specified in the instruction. So you can say the group it follows is branching group. You take down the five things which is not mentioned here in this slide. The format is address ADDR and the arrow towards PC. Which stands for program counter. Okay, so format is ADDR and arrow pointing towards PC for program counter. Then addressing mode you will write as immediate addressing mode. Then the third group you will write as branching group. Bytes you will write as 3 bytes. Flag you will be writing as none. Okay, how do we get 3 bytes here in this particular when we have address here? Since there is address which I have not mentioned in the instruction, there is address for this particular jump always. In both the jump we have two jumps, that is unconditional and conditional jump. So address is of 16 bit always in this particular instruction. So hence the 2 byte went for the operand, which is the data 16 bit address. So the 16 bit address took 2 bytes, correct, and plus 1 byte for JMP, the opcode. Okay, so total 3 bytes. So comment you will be writing in short as the control is transferred unconditionally to the memory location whose address is specified in the instruction. Okay, if you want to skip all of this you can write it down which I have dictated. Okay, so the next jump we'll be seeing is the same thing I have written, unconditional jump. Only the thing is long jump and short jump. So long jump, we only have long jump here. So 3 byte instruction, we do not use short jump in practical. So forget about the short jump and forget about the 8 bit address. Why? Because we always have 16 bit address. So hence it is said that long jump. So 3 byte instruction, first byte is opcode, second and third byte represents the 16 bit target address that I have mentioned in this particular slide. Okay, so the next jump, that is conditional jump. Now let us see for this conditional jump what do we have. Now note it down, the format as same ADDR, that is address, and the arrow pointing towards PC, which stands for program counter. Addressing mode is immediate addressing mode. Group is branching group. Bytes is 3 bytes. Flag is none. Okay, now what you will say for the explanation or comment, you can say in short, if you want to skip all of this in this slide, you will write the comment as that I'm dictating. In conditional jump instruction, the jump is taken only if the condition is true. Okay, the conditional jump instructions and the conditions are that there are total 8 conditions here now. okay, the jump in this particular conditional jump, the name itself is conditional jump. Why? Because it will only take the jump if the condition is true. If the condition that it follows is true, then only it will take a jump. Okay, so the conditions are, there are total 8 conditions noted down. See, in the next slide I've mentioned the conditions. See, the first condition is JZ. JZ address, if you can see, these are the conditions, okay? So JZ address, which is jump on zero. This particular instruction will jump only if the zero flag is set to 1. Okay, JZ means jump if zero. If there is a zero, then only it will jump. Okay, so the first condition is JZ, which stands for jump if zero. That means this particular instruction will take a jump only if the zero flag is set to 1 or if there is a zero flag. Okay, so second condition is JNZ address, which is jump on not zero. So this particular instruction will take a jump only if the zero flag is reset, or you can say if the zero flag is not set. So JZ means jump if zero, if the zero flag is set to 1. JNZ means if there is no zero, or if the zero flag is reset or set to zero, whatever. JC, which stands for jump on carry. So JC address means this particular instruction will take a jump only if the carry flag is set to 1. Jump if carry, if there is a carry, it will take a jump. JNC, which stands for jump if no carry. That means it will take a jump if the carry flag is reset or if the carry flag is not set, you can say. JP address, which means jump on plus. So this particular instruction will take a jump if the zero, if the sign flag, jump if plus and jump if minus, means these are the sign flag, there are two sign flag, correct? Plus, positive and negative. So plus and minus. Jump if plus, that means if the sign flag is not set to 1, if the sign flag is not set to 1, which means it is a plus symbol. And JM, which stands for jump if minus. So jump on minus means if this jump, if the sign flag is set, if it is 1, which means the sign flag is negative. Okay, so these are the 8 conditions that you need to follow. Here I have mentioned only 1, 2, 3, 6, I think. You need to mention 7th and 8th. I'll like dictate y'all. 7th one is JPO address. JPO ADDR, that is address. So in bracket you will write jump on odd parity, or parity odd, whatever. JPO in capital, and ADDR, which is address, and in the bracket you will write jump on parity odd or odd parity. So this particular instruction will take a jump if the parity flag is set to 0, which means there is a odd number of ones. Okay, then the next 8th one is JPE address, which stands for jump on parity even or even parity. So this particular instruction will take a jump if the parity flag is set to 1. If it is set to 1, that means we have even number of ones, correct? So there are total 8 conditions. I have mentioned 7 here. You take it down, the two more, that is JPO and JPE, jump on odd parity and jump on even parity. If P flag is equal to 0, that means odd. If P is equal to 1, that means even. Okay, so the conditional jump means it will take a jump only if it satisfies the condition or if the condition is true. And these are the conditions that it should follow. Either JZ, jump if 0, jump if no 0, jump if carry, jump if no carry, jump if plus, jump if minus, jump if parity even, jump if parity odd. Okay, so the next instruction, the third one, is call. C-A-L-L, call. Take down, because you will not be understanding reset, conditional call and return, which is the same. So hence I have written the whole thing together. So third is call, C-A-L-L address, which we again have two types here, unconditional and conditional. So we'll be seeing conditional first. Why? Because in the previous we also had seen conditional jump. Okay, so the same thing it is, but we call it as conditional call. What do you mean by a call? So you'll write the comment or explanation as here. All of the, now again, for this particular call, the addressing mode will be immediate addressing mode, bytes will be 3 bytes. Okay, the explanation you can say as the call instruction is used to call a subroutine unconditionally. okay, only one line if you want to mention, you can mention that. It is used to call as subroutine unconditionally. Subroutine is the main memory location which we say. Okay, so then you will write as the conditional call will make a call if the conditions are true, or it will make a call only if the it satisfies a certain condition, and the conditions are, these are the conditions which I have mentioned here. And again we have eight, same as jump, but only we used to say jump if carry, jump if no carry, but here we'll say call if carry, call if no carry. Okay, so instead of writing jump, you will write it as call. So CC, you will say call if carry. Subroutine, if you skip that part, will do. So call if carry flag is set to 1. CNC means call if carry flag is reset, or if no carry you can say. CC, call if carry. CNC, call if no carry. CZ means call if 0, that is 0 flag is equal to 1. CNZ, which is call if there is no 0 or 0 flag is reset, is equal to 0, whatever. CM, call if sign flag is set, which you can also say as call if minus, that is if sign flag is equal to 1, it is a negative number, minus. So CP means call if positive, also called as if the sign flag is set to 0 or reset, which is a positive number. So these are the conditional call which we saw first. In the next instruction, the fourth one is unconditional call, the last instruction in this particular video. So we total saw four instructions, that is jump unconditionally, then jump conditionally, same for call conditionally, and call unconditionally. Okay, you only take it down and revise once, because these instructions are not very important. So call unconditionally, we can say it is used to call a subroutine unconditionally. Sorry, before I said that the call is made only if it is used to make a call unconditionally from the subroutine, but for call conditionally, you will say it will make a call if it only satisfies the condition, or if the condition is true. And for unconditional, the same way you will say as it will make a call unconditionally from the subroutine. So there is nothing to say much about the unconditional call, because we don't have much in this. So you will write the sentence which I have made it in arrow part. The first sentence is, this instruction is used to call a subroutine, or also called as procedure, from the main program. I said, like I already said, the main program or main program that we write in the memory, it is used to make a call from that particular program. An address of that procedure may be specified directly or indirectly. So there are two types of procedure, depending upon whether it is available in the same segment or in another segment. If you want to skip this second particular statement, will do. You can take down the third statement. On execution, this instruction shows the incremented IP, that is Internet Protocol and CS code segment, into the stack and loads the CS and IP registers with the segment and offset addresses of the procedure to be called. You can take down two particular sentence, either first or second, or first or third, whichever you find it more easier. Okay, so in the second statement, I have taken an example as one near call, which is 32k displacement address, it is said to be. Or second is for call, that is anywhere outside the segment. If you find the difficult about writing these particular examples, you can skip and only write the sentence part. Okay, so thank you students. Today we completed with the four instructions in the particular branching group. We only have total eight instructions in this particular branching group. So the next four instructions will be seeing in the next particular video, and will be completing with the branching group, and will be starting with the last group shortly, and will complete with this particular chapter. So thank you students. I hope you all are taking down all of the instructions in a particular notebook. Okay, thank you.